Hello and welcome back. This is Sunil, and in this lecture I'm going to teach you and show you how to make this ball, which is a circle filled with green color here, to bounce within the boundaries of this canvas. So to save our time, I have already drawn this circle and filled the color, which we have already done in the previous section. So I'm not going to write those logics again, those codes again. Only thing I'm going to write here is the logic to make this bounce. Okay, so let's move to the JavaScript. So if you look at the code, only thing I have changed is I have changed this function name to bouncing, and I'm calling this on load of the HTML page, and I have changed this heading as usual to the bouncing ball. And here I'm writing this function bouncing and another function draw ball to draw the circle, which will be looking like a ball with a green color. So here, if you see, I'm taking the context, and then with the context I'm clearing the canvas, then begin path, and then fill style with a green color, and then I'm calling the arc function, and here I'm passing the initial x, initial y, and radius of the circle, initial angle and the final angle, and true. Okay, and then I'm closing the path, and then I'm the calling the context.fill to fill the color. And here I'm initializing initial x with 30, 20 and x and y, two variables that I have taken to write the logic for the bouncing ball. So that is not used it, only we have used this initial x and y, initial y. So if you look here, this I have defined here initial x and y so that the circle will start drawing from here. So we have the circle ready. Only thing we need to write, we need to move this. So to move this, it's a very simple logic which we have written earlier as well. We need to keep incrementing this initial x and y to make it a move. So we need to increment it, suppose plus 1 or initial y plus 1, and now we'll refresh. See here, now the ball is moving. Okay, so since x and y coordinates are changing, it is moving, but it is not bouncing back. So that's that logic we are going to write here. So to make it bounce back, what we need to do, we need to write a simple logic here. So let's understand here. So if you see here, it is starting from the 30, 20, and it is keep on incrementing, and it is crossing this boundary and going somewhere out of this canvas. So what we need to write the logic, we need to write the logic whenever the ball is coming to the end of the canvas coordinates or boundary, it should again go back. So whenever, suppose this is 350 and 400, so whenever x is becoming 350 or y is becoming 400 here, and 401, it should keep decreasing, like 400, whenever x is y is becoming 400, it should start decreasing it, like 390 380, and so that the ball will be coming this way. Same way, same thing with the x. If x is becoming 350, it should start decreasing, and whenever it is becoming 0, it should start incrementing it. So that logic will be writing here. So to write that, I have been given here x and y, two variables, so that whenever we need to increment or decrement, we'll use this x and y. So here what I do, I'll put x and I'll put y. Okay, so now see, now it is moving faster because the coordinates are changing faster, because earlier it was changing with 1, now it is changing with 7. So now one thing we need to do, we need to make it bounce back. So for that, I need to write a logic, which is I need to take the initial x. So I have to check with initial x is less than 0. Whenever initial x is becoming less than 0, or initial x is greater than 350, because x coordinate is 350 and y is 400, what we need to do, we need to make this, we are adding initial x plus x. So we need to make this x negative in if it is 350. If it is 350, it should be decreasing. So 350 minus something. So here what we need to do, we need to give x equal to minus x. Okay, so let's see. See here, if you look at here, when it is coming here and it is going back, since x is coming back but y is still going, it is not bouncing correctly. It is bouncing only on the here, not on the other way. From here it is going. So the same thing we need to write for y coordinate as well. So what I do, I'll paste here, I'll change it to initial y, and I have to make it 400, and here I need to make it y. So let's see now. See, now it is coming and it is bouncing again and again. It is not crossing the canvas limit because we have restricted the coordinates. Whenever it is coming 400, becoming 400 plus, see here, plus, it will become minus 7. So 400 minus 7, it will become 397, 3, and so on. It will be keep on decreasing, and whenever it will become 0, it keep on increasing. Okay, so in this way we can make this ball bouncing. So next thing what we can do, we can, like, if you remove this clear rect and try to draw, what will happen, see here, it will paint the canvas with the green color, because since it is not fully painted, you can see the movement, and after sometimes you will see it is fully painted. See here, now we have, with this we are seeing a cool graphics here. It is, and finally it will be fully painted. See here, the whole canvas will be green, and after that you can't see the ball because it is fully green and ball is also green. So see here, now it's fully drawn. See here, see. So with your imagination and practice, you can create more visual effects and animation. Okay, we can put it back, and we can also change this like 50 and 400 and see here, now it will be starting from here. It will not cross this one, x-axis, because it's starting from the 50. See here. Okay, so you can change this as well, 40, and see here, now it is coming like this. See, so based on your imagination, you can draw the graphics and animations. You can change this also and see. Okay, now what I do, I'll just copy this one circle thing, and I'll try to draw one more circle. Okay, and I will make it x1 and y1. I'll change the coordinate to 40, 10, change it to 30, and I'll change it to x1, y1. I'll write this logic again. x1, y1, x1, y1. Okay, so let's see. See here, now we are drawing two circles. See here how it is coming. Something wrong here, even. Okay, let me change this x and y also, because it is overlapping. X and y values are changing twice, so that is creating a problem. So let me make x1, y1, and then here x1, and then y1. So now let's see. See, now it is drawing with green and red. Okay, so let me put this 350, 400 to see the circles clearly. See that there are two balls, but we are seeing only one because coordinates are same. So let me change the initial one. Make it 100. See here, now we have two balls and both are moving. Okay, so you can now you can change something here like 250, 400 and see. Or you can make 300 and see. So this way you can play around with the coordinates and keep drawing something cool. Okay, so see you in the next lecture.